not by normal methods of learning can this knowledge be gained. Even spiritually, where how can we get this knowledge when we go and listen to someone who knows? Then whatever we hear, if we understand, we will remember. And the knowledge being so subtle, we have to listen to it again and again and again. And to reflect on it, we may have to discuss, speak about it, etc. Which other means of knowledge do you know? Or Google it. Yeah. Here the teacher points out, Nayam Atma. This Atma is not Pravachanena Labhya, gained through elaborate or through eloquent discourses. So you might become a great, you know, the times people come up to me, Swamiji, I want to learn how to talk, how to give lectures. Where do I go to learn it? Atma is not giving by eloquent lectures or discourses. No, I don't lecture. I go to listen to every lecture in town. No. Nahi bahuna shrutena. Not by listening. Na medhaya. Not by sitting and memorizing the shlokas also. Thank you, Swamiji. I've been coming for all the lectures. I've been coming for all the camps. Now I know. I was just thinking about it, you know. It's time for me to retire now. Not by plenty of listening. Yeah, I think now, instead of listening, I should go and start lecturing, taking classes. And then those who start taking classes, they don't attend any other discourses because now they can speak. So, yeah, I'll give pravachans, I will give talks, I will teach. By that also it's not gain. No, I'm going to memorize everything. By mere memory and chanting also, it cannot be gained. What the teacher is saying, not that one should not listen to it. In fact, Swadhyaya and Pravachan, those who came for Take the Big Step and those who came for Soar High, how often it was repeated to the point of, you know, a crime in the Upanishads. 14 times, Swadhyaya Pravachan, Swadhyaya Pravachan, Swadhyaya Pravachan. The only means to gain knowledge is Shravan Manan Nididhyasan. You know? Listening, reflecting, meditating. And how do you do that? By studying and by spreading. No? And suddenly, what is this telling us? What it's saying is that you might listen for 100 years. Only listen. You may be able to give elaborate discourses, eloquent discourses. Know the commentaries of Shankaracharya, Anandgiri, and all others back and forth in Sanskrit. You even have such a good memory that you can memorize all the Upanishads. You can repeat it front side, back side, every side, you know. If any of these some special ingredient missing, then it is not effective. Just to give you an example, one young couple got married, and as always they like nowadays to have their house on their own. So the young couple living in one small little studio apartment away from their home city so that they can stay away from their in-laws. just got married. But whatever said and done, she's a very devoted wife. Cooks very well. And she's a new bride, most of all. And he in his office, when he goes, everybody tells, "Hari, you got married? When are you calling us home for a party?" So he just calls up. He's a new husband yet. He calls up and says, "I'm bringing my friends today. In the evening, I've told them that you cook very well. They're all looking forward for your food. Be ready by 7 o'clock. If she was a seasoned wife, she would have said, "Take them to a restaurant. Bang. Which is a new wife. She's in panic. He's bringing 5 people home and he's just telling now in the afternoon. She runs to the supermarket, picks up quickly whatever she can pick up. She even remembers to pick up the soft drinks, etc. Everything she has brought, she comes home and quickly she takes out that special blender which she got as a wedding gift, the $2,000 blender that every woman is looking for these days in Australia. So that she doesn't have to cut vegetables, she doesn't have to do this, she doesn't have to do everything. You just put inside and everything comes out all ready made. The dream blender. And it just comes out, and then she's got everything ready at the same time, and then she puts all these vegetables and rice, etc. on the electric stove or gas stove? Okay, on the gas stove. She puts them on the gas stove, and he's about to come now, 6:45, and because she's a new bride, everybody wants her to be dolled up, to be shown as a masterpiece. So quickly she manages to wear the best sari, and simple thing is just open up your hair. She opens up her hair, and then just when she puts that big tikka on her head, the bell rings. Perfect. And she stands there welcoming everybody. And everybody says, "What a beautiful wife you've got." And he says, but they come, Bhabhi, "We are so hungry." He tells you, "Cook very nicely." He never tells in front of me. But cooks very nicely. And he looks at her and says, "Get it ready." She comes, gives the drinks. She even brings some snacks, chips, etc. And she keeps it there. Everything is ready. And she goes into the kitchen now. And everybody's saying, "We are hungry. We are waiting to eat the food." Because the whole day they have been in the office eating sandwiches. So now they are hungry. And she goes into the kitchen. She doesn't come out. So he just smiles. She was getting a very special meal ready. Till finally she doesn't come out. He goes inside. She is weeping away. What happened? She picks up all the lids. Nothing is cooked. Whole day she has cut vegetables, she's marinated them, she has thrown spices into it, everything, it's not cooked. Now how can she serve the meal? $2,000 bread blender. Because she forgot to put the fire on. You do all this, but the fire is not there. Gone to waste, you know. Cooked food cannot be had. You buy someone a gift for their wedding. You spend a lot of money on it. You don't have your heart in giving that gift. When you give, come to your wedding, take it. However, you take even one flower and with your heart say, "I went searching for this flower just because it had the color of your cheeks. I thought of you and I brought it just for you. Without that ingredient of love, can any gift be useful? You do a job. You put in your best in that job, but your heart is not in that job. You use all the formulae that you learn in your management course, but your heart is not in that job. Will it have that efficiency and that effectiveness? You're telling someone, you're looking very handsome, but you don't mean it. Does those words have any impact? The only means to gain knowledge is listen and keep on listening till you understand. To reflect, you speak to others about it, not preach, but you share with others, pravachan. And what you have to speak out to others, you'll have to reflect, think. And what you think and speak, you will never forget. That's why you find most people in discussion group repeat the same thing only. Because what they have said, they will never forget. These are the means to know. But what Yamraj says, by listening alone, by speaking on it alone, by memorizing or remembering it alone, one does not discover this Atma. Then who does? Yame vaisha vrunute tena labhya. Formation of this line is so beautiful. Vrunate chooses. Whoever chooses this, this means chooses this Atma alone. Tena labhya. They indeed gain it. Which means that one who chooses this Atma alone, when he listens about it, he gains it. When he speaks on it, he sees it. When he remembers it, he revels in it. Otherwise, by merely listening, merely speaking, merely memorizing, one does not get it.